الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله يجتبي إليه من يشاء ويهدي إليه من ينيب. صدق الله العظيم. Yesterday we were talking about this ayah of Quran al-Kareem, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mentioned the rule of the hidayah, and that is وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يُنِيبُ. Allah guides towards Him those who repent to Him. This is the rule of the hidayah. And I was mentioning yesterday that a lot of time people have a question about hidayah, that hidayah is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If He wants, He will grant us the hidayah. Sometimes the kuffar used this argument also before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala controls the hidayah. If He wants, He will give me the hidayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned some of those situations in Quran also, when they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and presented this type of argument. فَانْتَقُولُوا إِنَّمَا أُنزِلُ الْكِتَابُ عَلَىٰ طَائِفَتَيْنِ مِنْ قَبْلِنَا وَإِن كُنَّا عَنْ دِرَاسَتِهِمْ لَغَافِلِينَ أَوْ تَقُولُوا لَوْ أَنَّا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْنَا الْكِتَابُ لَكُنَّا أَهْدَى مِنْهُمْ فَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بَيِّنَةٌ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, less at the end you would say that if we had received Quran, if a book was revealed to us, we would have been more guided than those people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I have revealed the Quran to you people. فَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بَيِّنَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ. You got clear proof from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you got the guidance, and you got the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these things are available to you. It's only now you accepting this hidayah. So the rule of hidayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned is وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يُنِيبُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides towards Him those who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which means inaba is something that is needed from human beings in order for them to get the hidayah and to receive the hidayah. What does inaba means? Inaba means to turn towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to cry before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of this is hidayah, inaba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us simply in this ayah that if a person would consider himself independent and does not need anything from me, if Allah wants, He will give me this. If He wants, He will give me the hidayah. I will not give hidayah in that way. If a person really needs hidayah, if a person needs guidance from me, any type of guidance, if a person needs that guidance from me, then this person has to turn towards me. He has to present his need to me. Ya Allah, I need the hidayah from you. I need the guidance from you. I need you, Ya Allah. When a person would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I open the doors of hidayah for this person. So inaba is needed. This is why some of the scholars have written in their books about when they told some of the non-Muslims to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and especially this dua, Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqa wa rizukna attiba'ah wa arina al-batila batila wa rizukna ijtinabah. Not necessarily in Arabic, but at least reading the meaning of this dua. That Ya Allah, show me the right path and give me tawfiq to follow it. And give me the right understanding of the wrong things and tawfiq to stay away from it. that this was experienced where even when a non-Muslim, when he starts praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with these type of prayers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens their heart for the hidayah. Because this is inabana. This person is turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not only Rabbul Mu'mineen, He is Rabbul Alameen. He is the Lord of the whole universe. So even when a non-Muslim turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is a person who's confused. He doesn't know what to do. There are people sometimes that approach us, that I don't know what to do. I have been studying different religions. I'm looking for the right path, but I don't know where that is. This person has studied different religions. He may even have read something about Islam. But still, there is confusion in his mind. People are telling him different things. He is seeing different things. Therefore, he has questions. When this person would turn to Allah, Allah is there. Rabb is there. He believes there is God. He doesn't know how to obey God. He doesn't know which of these directions will lead him straight to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which religion should he choose so that he can please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and get the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the confusion. He's sure about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He shows that there is Rabb, there is Allah, there is Creator. But he doesn't know how to follow the instructions given by Rabb subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you ask this person to make this dua. Tell this person to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You believe there is God, so pray to God. Just pray to God that, Ya Allah, whichever direction is the right one for me, allow me to choose that one. Whichever religion, whichever way of life is the right one for me, give me tawfiq to follow that one. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. This is the message of this dua. And as I said, scholars have written in their books about their experience that when a person would make this dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open their hearts for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Islam. So of course, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides a kafir who repents, imagine when a mu'min repents. Mu'min, at least through his iman, is closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than a kafir. At least he has the kalima in his heart. He has the name Muhammad Rasulullah in his heart. So when a person of iman would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens his doors, the doors of his heart, for the hidayah and for the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The doors of the rahmah, the door of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they start opening to the heart of this person. وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يُنِيبُ. And Allah guides towards him those who would repent to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Quran that some of the previous nations were destroyed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they stopped repenting to Allah. When the whole nation, they stopped repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there was no repentance. No one is turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed those nations. We need to remember one thing. Whenever a person needs anything in this life, we always think about someone who can help us in this situation. Someone who can make that phone call for us. Someone who can open the door for us. Someone who can treat us. Someone who can buy it for us. Someone who can guide us to where to buy it from. Whatever a person needs, we always look for help in that situation. We need to fix something in the house. If we know how to fix it, then we look for the store that will sell us the material. Then we can buy so that we can fix it. So we need someone's help. After buying the material, I'm missing one of the tools. I will look for someone who may have that tool. If I don't know how to use it, now I will look for someone that will teach me. I don't know how to fix it, I will look for someone who would fix it for me. But we always need someone's help. Human being by himself is nothing, can do nothing. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the system of this universe. That we all need each other, and we need the support, and we need to get the support from other people. A person needs food. Where am I going to get the food from? After getting hungry, I'm going to start cultivating the land. We know that. We need other people who are doing all of that work. They're doing all the farming. And then there are people who are bringing that vegetable, that fruit, all of that food, and then making it available into the market. So we need these people now. And then for these people to sell it to us. And now we need the money to buy. There are a lot of needs. Human beings are full of needs. And for each and everything that we need, there are so many things, there are so many needs that are attached one after another. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the system in such a way that there are people who are working on our behalf so that these things are available to us. How much work is being done so that we get some light in this place? For people to have those machines that are generating the electricity, and the companies that are taking care of those machines, and then having the wiring all the way from there to here, and how many people may have worked over that wiring and making sure that it stays intact, and then it will keep on providing us with the electricity that we need, and then getting it from the road up to here, and then having this light, and the factories that are making these lights, the companies that are making these lights. And just start thinking about it, maybe thousands of people work behind just one thing that we are using. And we are getting it so inexpensive that if we start adding the price and adding the value of every person that worked on it, we will never be able to pay for it. But getting it inexpensive too. This is the whole system. So this is the nature of a human being, that we are always in need. And whenever we need something, then we look for someone or something that will help us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through Anbiya alayhim salatu wa salam, He taught us one thing. That whenever you feel that you are in need of something, before you turn to anyone, anything, first thing turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First thing, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is called inaba. That this person now developed the habit of turning towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever he wants something, before he will look for a light switch, he will say Bismillah. He will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before he would look for food, first thing he will make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before he will look for a house, he will make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before he will look for a glass to get his water from, he will turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the habit that Anbiya alayhim salatu wasalam were teaching their followers, and especially this is what we see in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Continuously he's teaching us that whatever you need, whatever situation you're in, first thing turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, when a person would have the habit of turning to Allah in small things, then when major things will take place, will happen, then for sure he will be turning to Allah even more. when this habit is not there, that human beings are just depending on each other. I have to go and talk to that person. And I don't know if this person would do it or not. If a person has his connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the habit of turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then this person will turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Allah, I need this thing. And I know, Ya Allah, you put my need in the hand of that person. You are the one who put it there. He does not have any power over it. If you want, regardless of this person, what this person wants, my need will be fulfilled. And I know, Ya Allah, if you don't want this thing to happen, if the whole world will get together and they are in my favor and they would like to do it for me, it will not happen. This is why in some of the du'as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, مَنْ كَانَتْ لَهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ حَاجَةٌ أَوْ إِلَى أَحَدٍ مِّنَ النَّاسِ. If a person has a need directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or a need that he feels is in the hand of someone, a human being like him, this person should perform these two rak'ahs and then perform two rak'ah salah and then should make this du'a. Allah will make his need easy to be fulfilled. Hearts are in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لِيَسْأَلْ أَحَدُكُمْ رَبَّهُ كُلْ شِيْءٍ. Get into the habit of asking Allah for everything. Then he says, even if you are walking on the street and your shoelace broke, normally when the shoelace breaks, what we would do? Normally, okay, let me tie it up in some other way. Okay, I can pull it up a little bit. Then I can go home and take another shoes. I have another shoes at home. I have another pairs at home. Or there is a store just next door. Let me stop over there and buy another lace. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, it's so simple, easy for you to get it. But first thing, as soon as it breaks and you know that you need another one, first thing, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I mean, things that are available to you. And then you have very easy access to them. But still, we need to be of the habit of turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First thing, turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لِيَسْأَلْ رَبَّكُمْ أَحَدُكُمْ رَبَّهُ حَتَّى الْمِلْحِ. Ask Allah for all of your needs, even if you need some salt. And you know that if there is no salt in the house, in your kitchen, then the next door neighbor will give it to you. And he's talking in those days, especially when people, you're having houses close to each other. And the general thing was in the house that when women, they see that there is something they don't have, especially these type of things, there is no salt, or I need some little bit of water for cooking and there is nothing over there, or I need little wood for putting on the fire and it's not there. Right away she will go to the next door neighbor and tell them, you know, I need this thing, can you just give me a little bit? So it's not that you don't even have to go to the store at this time to buy it. Everyone knows you can get it right there. If you don't have it, your neighbors have it. And they will give it to you. These minor things, small things, in Arabic language, they are called ma'un. They are called ma'un. And there is surah in Quran, surah al-ma'un. أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يُكَذِّبُ بِالدِّينِ. And at the end of the surah, الَّذِينَ هُمْ يُرَاءُونَ وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَاعُونَ. So in those days, it was very general habit that if someone doesn't have anything in the house, right away, you mean these type of things, you go to the next door neighbor and they will give it to you. And it's not that you even have to return it to them. I mean, this is just salt, take it. See, in the old days, these type of connection, morality, family life, these things were there. And people were close to each other. Nowadays, Subhanallah, the way our hearts are apart, we like to be as far as possible from other people. And really, if you see it, we can see that when you travel around the town, especially we are sitting at a good location here to understand this example, you go to old neighborhoods, you will see houses are close to each other. Go to the new neighborhoods, houses are far apart from each other. In old days, people used to build their house close to each other. There was connection. They used to look forward to have their house to be very next door to the next person's house, right there, so that any time right away you run there. And now, you know that you will be only getting hardships and problems from neighbors. So it's better to keep your house as far away from the neighbors as possible. And here, you see, in the old neighborhoods, houses are close. You go to the new neighborhoods, houses are far apart. So this is always there. So, and nowadays, يَمْنَعُونَ الْمَعُونَ. You don't even like someone knocking at your door asking for salt, asking for water. We don't like people coming to us, even for these minute things. So anyway, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, even if it is something that small, just have the habit of turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't do anything without turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and first thing asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fulfill your need, and then go ahead and do it, fulfill it whichever way you think, worldly means, using the worldly means and however you think that you can fulfill it. But first thing, have the habit of turning to Allah. This is a habit that Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam always told their followers to have and to develop in their lives. When the ummah starts going away from it, and when people start losing this habit initially, it will be for minor things. Okay, I have the key in my pocket. My car is parked over there and I'm going out. What the dua is needed for? Why do I have to do anything right now? You know, when I don't have the car, then I will pray to Allah to give me a car. This is our normal situation. If I don't have a home, then I will ask Allah to give me a home. When I don't have something and I feel that it's difficult for me to get it, then I will turn to Allah. But right now I have this. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching us that even if you have it, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and then start using it. You will be using it only with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many times it happens that everything is ready? You walk out, I don't know what happened to my keys. I just had it. Few minutes ago I had it in my hand, but I can't find my keys. Sometimes you have the key, it's not opening the door. This is the same key that opens it all the time. Today it's not opening the door. We get into the car, and we started our journey. 2 minutes later, you receive a phone call. Right away you have to take a U-turn and go back home. My feeling was, I have my car, the car is full, the gas is there, then everything is there, and I don't need anything. So initially, we start turning away from these small needs, and we just depend on ourselves or our things. Gradually, now the person starts going away and away, until even for the major needs, the person does not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was approached by the kuffar of Quraysh with some questions about Islam that would prove that he is a true messenger of Allah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, come back to me tomorrow and I will give you the answers. He forgot to say inshaAllah. Next day when they came, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't have the answer for them. I didn't get the answer. I have to wait until I get it. Now these people are bugging him continuously. They come to him the day after, and the third day, and the fourth day, and the fifth day. 14 days, and he doesn't have no answer. On the 15th day, he receives the revelation saying, وَلَا تَقُولَنَّ لِشَيْءٍ إِنِّي فَاعِلٌ ذَلِكَ غَدًا إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ. Don't say about anything that you would do it tomorrow without saying inshallah. Because you did not say inshallah, we delayed the revelation, the wahi, for 15 days. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching the lessons to Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam. We make this mistake day and night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not punish us for that. We are not at that level. If we stand instead getting punished for these things, and if our needs will be postponed because of these type of mistakes, we won't be able to get anything done. But of course, this is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who doesn't do anything without turning to Allah. At this time he said it, he said, I will give you the answer tomorrow without inshaAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to teach him the lesson, how important this inshaAllah is, to mention Allah's name and to put the trust only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah wills, I will give you the answer tomorrow. Then he delayed that wahi for 15 days. So when this becomes the situation of the whole nation, the whole nation turns away from Allah, wal-ayyazu billah. They don't repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't have the quality of repentance. No one in this nation gets up at night time to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one in this nation raises his hand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That habit of repentance, of turning to Allah, is gone away from this nation. Then the doors of the adab starts opening up. Wal-ayyazu billah. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمَمٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَضَرَّعُونَ. We sent messengers to the nations before you, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَضَرَّعُونَ. Then, when those people rejected the message of Anbiya عليهم الصلاة والسلام, we got them into hardships and difficulties. And the purpose of making them go through hardships and difficulties was so that لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَضَرَّعُونَ, so that they will turn to me, they will repent to me, they will cry before me. فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا. But when my punishment came, what was the reason these people did not turn to me even at that time? They did not cry before me. They started going at every other door. They started knocking all the other doors in the world. They started crying before people like them. They started using all the other worldly means, but they did not turn to me. فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا. What was the reason that when my azab came, when the hardship came on them, when the difficulties started befalling these people, they did not repent to me. They did not turn to me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَكِنْ حَسَدْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. But their hearts were too hard. By this time, all of them, they were gone so far from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they had turned so far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that their hearts got too hard now. And even after seeing the signs of azab, the signs of punishment, these people are not turning to Allah and they are not repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And shaitan beautified their deeds to them. Look, you're doing enough. You're doing so much. You don't need to do anything more. وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Shaitan beautified their deeds to them. And really, a lot of times after we see the hardships coming, and after the people see the difficulties befalling them, still they start doing more of those evils. Not only this, they want to invite everyone to do these evils, hoping that these evils will take these hardships away from them. You see, people are staring, inviting other Muslims to commit more sins. You know, we all together should do these things. All Muslim women should take their hijab off. All men, take their beard off. Stop going to the masjid now. These are not the days for it. وَلَكِنْ وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Shaitan beautified their deeds to them. Keep on doing more of this evil, and then you will be able to get rid of the hardship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, by this you are in fact inviting more adhaab from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, the ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. The same word, أَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. Repent to your Lord. وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. And submit yourself to Him. Two requirements. وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. Repent to your Lord. Repent to your Rabb subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep this habit of repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. And submit yourself to your Rabb subhanahu wa ta'ala. مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابِ. Before the adab would come, ثُمَّ لَا تُنصَرُونَ. Then you will not get any help if adab will start befalling. Repentance is required to keep the adab away. Two things. Inaba and istislam. Repent to Allah and submit yourself to Allah. Ya Allah, this is what you want me to do? Okay, this is what I will do. But first thing, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Allah, I have done a lot of wrong. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anibu ila rabbikum wa aslimu lahu. Turn to your Allah, repent to your Rabb subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa aslimu lahu. And submit yourself to Him. Min qabli an ya'tiyakum al-'adhab. Before the adab would come. Thumma la tunsaroon. And once the adab would come, then you will not get any help from anywhere. Then no one will be able to help you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us tawfiq to have this habit of repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that we always keep on repenting to our Rabb subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we develop this habit of turning to Allah, praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and spending some time when we would turn to Allah, we would repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we would ask Allah for forgiveness for all of our past, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the hidayah, and for the iman, and for the hidayah of our future generations, and we cry before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the situation of the ummah and for the situation of the world. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of us. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa lisa'iril muslimin wal muslimat wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah.